and you plant. If you don't plant corn or yam, put it back beside, we live in another one. So when you give, you are expecting that it's a seed and it will grow and be forth the one that is bigger. And I remember in those days when I used to follow one of my own people farm, when the planting season is near, he normally select the one that had the best, the one that does not have all this bad something, something as eating it, as eating it, or the one that is already dying. They select the best and clean it very well. You know, because in the time here, they will still put up, they will clean it. If it's too big, they cut it, but they clean it and clean it very well and put it back to the ground. They pamper it. Some that want to keep it, they will keep it in a very good place. We have moisture, and this will be very good. But some people, they want to bring money to church, they bring the smallest one. I go out. Some they bring 1 second, 2 second. Because they calculate all their problem. Let me tell you, if you are looking at your problem will continue, but if you look at solution, you will get solution. Problem will always come. But if you look at solution, there will always be solution. Why? Because I have said many are the afflictions of the righteous. Say for the Lord, make it overcome them all. He keep it and go, and none of them is broken. Stop looking at the magnitude of what I'm facing. Look at Jesus. Obey him. Follow him. Do what he asks you to do. He wants you to be meat to his house. He said, command men. Let's go look at Malachi chapter 3.
The fatherless, the torn aside the strangers from the land of his right.
again, said the Lord of hosts, that is, everyone that is doing evil in the land is going to come against them. Verse 6, that said, for you have known, I change it not. Therefore, ye sons of Jacob are not consumed. God does not change. He said, now let's tell them, has God changed? Has God changed?
No.
We should read that book, understand it. It's not like what Jesus. Verse 7, now says, verse 7, he says, even from the days of your fathers, ye have gone away from my ordinances, and have not kept them. Return unto me, and I will return unto you, said the Lord of hosts. You have not kept my laws. You have not kept God's ordinances. Laws, you have not kept my obligations. You have not done what I have to do. Pay your time, come to my house, watch me do this. You have not done that. Said, return back to me, repent, and I will come back to you. He has to repent. He now asks the first thing, he says, will a man rob God? Say, yea, he has robbed me. But he said, where have you robbed him? He said, in tithes and what? An offering. Then, he now said, you are cursed with a curse. That will not be your portion in Jesus' name. Say, for you have robbed me, even this whole nation. Say, bring all your tithes into the storehouse, that there may be meat in my house. Prove me now. Herewith, said the Lord of hosts, if I will not open you the windows of heaven and pour you out a blessing, that there shall not be room enough to receive it. That's why God says, you pay offering, you pay your tithe, he is going to open the window of heaven. Say, blessing is so much that you don't have enough room. Why is it not happening? I was talking about dominion this morning, what God said. Why are we not living in dominion? There are certain things that make us not to have it. Certain is not the plan of God for our life. But certain things, certainly I'm not allowed to receive enough blessing, enough blessing. But today, anything that is blocking you shall give way.
Amen.
And the glory of God will shine over your life.
Amen.
You shall receive multiple blessings in Jesus' name. Are you for that? He doesn't say, I will rebuke the voters, verse 11. For your sake. And these have not destroyed the fruit of your ground. Say amen to that.
Amen.
That's how you find cast out fruit before the time in the field. Send them up to say, and all nations shall call you blessed. Say amen. For you shall be a delightsome land, said the Lord of hosts. Your word has been stamped against me, said the Lord. Amen. Let me just stop here. God wants us to bring, he said, he said, meat, bring me to my house. That's what he said. If we leave that place very well, he said, bring me. Why will you allow me to finish in the house? That's what God said. He doesn't begin to question our contribution in the house of God. Begin to question it. What are you contributing to yourself alone? Particularly in the time of meat, when Bible says meat, it's talking about making provisions for yourself. Making provision for the church. I've said this several times that this church has not yet started to deliver the money. They don't receive salary yet. Pastor does not receive salary. Is that because you don't like anybody's face? You say you stop tight. It's the business between you and God. Are you fighting with God? Can man fight with God? But our actions show that we are against God. Stop tight. Our actions show that we are fighting that problem with God. I just gonna tell you, nobody can pollute your money that bring to the house of God. And they put on this on the shoulder. Nobody can pollute it. If anybody wants to pollute it, it's polluting his life. So why are you afraid? What's your fear? What's your fear? If you listen to Job very well last week, he makes mess also on that. Those of you, if you listen to that, it's mess last week. He says, people are afraid when they go to bring their money to pastor. They pass on to chop up. When pastor chop on the leprosy in job, the pastor eats your money, he has eaten leprosy, sawdust. Sawdust they digest. You know they digest. May God deliver us. How did that came about? I've mentioned somebody I want to put the message again. So I'm running up there. How did that came about? In the Genesis, Genesis chapter 4. Five kings gathered together against some other four kings. king was the king of Sodom and Gomorrah. Though this other king had defeated them, and they carried Lot, who was Abraham's nephew, I think. They carried him into captivity. And somebody brought the news to Abraham and said, Abraham, they carry your brother. And the man who came to prepare his army, he has an army. He went after them and he conquered those five kings. He now brought back all the goods that those people have collected. They collected all those days. When they go to war, they collect goods too. See, so they are valuable things. So, all these things that they have collected now, it belongs to who? Everybody, somebody conquered and collected things. And when Abraham was conquered, he said, it belongs to Abraham. So, they now brought to Abraham the key back kings now that he had, the other king that he had, through the company of Sodom and Gomorrah. They now brought the thing to Abraham that Abraham see all the things that you collected from these people. He now said, I don't need it to. God is always blessing me, but I need 10% of it. He now collected 10% of it and gave it to a man called Melchizedek, the king of Salem. The man who told us, go to New Testament, the New Testament that we are saying that he didn't tell anything about it, is what I explained to the man who the man was very well. He said, the man has no father, he has no mother. It's a mystery. He's the king of peace and the king of righteousness. Who is the king of peace?
Jesus.
Who is the king of righteousness? He has no father, he has no mother. He came to welcome Abraham when Abraham was coming from the war. He said, you have conquered. Don't worry, come and sit. Come and eat. And Abraham collected 10% and paid to him. And God continued to bless Abraham the more. So before I know the Lord came, Abraham paid tithe. His children paid tithe. The bad thing with Abraham pay. God knows where asked Abraham to pay. It was in Malachi first started. Later that God now prayed in Deuteronomy, that God now prayed out the law that we should not be paying tithe. But before he wasn't there. And he paid. Because he knows that it's God that sustains, God that sent me. He wants more blessing. But here we are, you want to chop your and chop the one for God. If you chop your seed, what are you going to plant? That was how you see him as an example. The yams are going to plant, you chop out. I want something to do. Will it happen like that? Mbado. It's not like that. May God bless in Jesus' name.
Amen.
So if I'm defaulting tithe, go to God and ask God to forgive you and start paying it. Maybe what I've been enjoying is grace. Grace has a limit. Now say you cannot continue in sin and say grace you are bad. Say God forbid. Grace has a limit. That's why some people run into a problem, and before you know it, I have one news recently that I feel bad. Somebody who left Israel, they said they have this thing. And now, the lady speaker has to come back. Why? Because nothing again. Then where are the things that you have gathered together? If you gather without God, if you go, that will not be your portion in Jesus' name.
Amen.
I say it will not be your portion in Jesus' name. Offering is compulsory. That means you don't come to my presence empty-handed. Don't come. Deuteronomy is there. Don't come to me empty-handed. Deuteronomy chapter 16. When you come to the presence of God, you must drop something. In fact, you are casting that will be the deal. We still pray off. We still drop off. Workers meeting. The God will pray as the house of God. Workers meeting. We still pray off. But that means don't come to my presence empty. So offering is a normal thing that you have to pay. Another one is all these vow, contributions, seed of faith. Keep to God. God can always listen to you, can always answer you. And I pray we answer you in Jesus' name.
Amen.
What are the benefits for bringing your meat to the house of God? What are the benefits? Try to rush so that I will not delay you. Number one. Your meat in the house of God, your money, your tithe, will stand against any evil thing that want to come to you. You can stand against any evil program. He has a voice and he can speak. Sacrifice of David spoke. is it last week or which other day was speaking? And then the other service, that's the voice. Because what Dr. Cass was doing, the good thing, the good he was doing, that made people to cry to the upper Peter to come and kill. Cornelius, it was the arms he was given that made God to send Peter to arms he was given. Number two, so that nothing will stand against you in prayers. When you don't obey God or say you want to obey, you are giving Satan the ground to stand against you. Say, the prince of this world cometh, and he found nothing in me. If Job was not righteous, he was not giving hands, paying money, praying, I don't think you have survived the onslaught of Satan. God was very proud of him because he was always offering sacrifice, always doing things right. Number three, when you pray, I've said before, what he blesses. You don't see, even the blessing you didn't ask for, you will get it. Though you have to act in faith too. Because one day to pray that you must follow with faith. I believe that that's your tithe, your offering will work for you. Number four, God will always intercede in your matter. You intercede. Anything that concerns you, God will always be there. Number five, you will bring angelic assistance. Angelic assistance. That you will bring that angel. They will work on your behalf. You bring that angelic assistance. Number six, heaven will always honor you. Anywhere you go, you see honor. Everyone will always follow you. If I'm faithful in bringing me to God, God will honor you. Number seven, you can never go to death. If I'm faithful to tithe, you can never, never go to death. When you need money, money will come. I used to tell people that if I need money before you know it, God will provide for me. Because my salary is very poor. I'm just a pastor, I'm a full-time pastor. But when it comes to lack, I don't lack. God is always there. And that God will be there for you in Jesus' name. Amen. I said, God will be there for you in Jesus' name. Amen. You know, my total obedience to what God required for me. As I ran the letter from Luke 16. Luke chapter 16. Verse 10 and 11. He that is faithful in that which is least is faithful also in much. He that is unjust in the least is unjust in most. Verse 11. If therefore ye have not been faithful in unrighteous mammon, who will commit your trust? Who will commit to your trust the true riches? Amen. You don't understand? He said, if you are not faithful to little thing, you cannot be faithful to God. And if you are not faithful, how will God then commit bigger things to God? That's what he said. I pray that God have mercy on us, have mercy on the church, and not stop his mercy upon us in Jesus' name. That's why I want to bow down your head and you to talk to God. Are you faithful to people tell you that if you are not faithful, I'm sorry, have the mercy upon you. Do not allow your wrath, your anger, to come upon me. In Jesus' name, we pray. As I was sitting up, praying this prayer, I said, arrow of disobedience.
Arrow of disobedience.
To what it may God to be happy with me. Arrow of disobedience. To everything that will make God to be happy with me. Mercy of God. Pour for me now and cast them out. In the name of Jesus, every arrow of disobedience inside my life has not made God to be happy with me. Mercy of God, work for me and cast them out. In Jesus' name, pray. See, any good thing that disobedience has stolen from my life, I command to come back. In the name of Jesus. Any good thing that disobedience has taken away from my life, come back to me. Come back to me. In Jesus' name, pray. Any more prayers set over my life, backfire in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, pray. Power that want to waste my service to God. You are a liar. Die. In the name of Jesus. Any power that want to waste my service to God. In Jesus' name, pray. Say, mercy of God. Locate me today. Mercy of God. Locate me today. And cancel all my debts. In the name of Jesus. Locate me today. And cancel all of my debts. In Jesus' name, pray. I shall be blessed. And be relevant. Whether that's it, I like it or not. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name, pray. Please, I want to beg for patience. In the next 10 minutes, we close. We still have a small Thanksgiving. If you are able to tithe, please kindly come out. If you are able to tithe, please come out.
You will never say no.
limitation should be destroyed in their life, in their marriage. Pray that satanic decree will never come upon their life. Ask God to keep their own, to honor them. Pray that every battle that we stand against them, God should destroy them. And nothing of this should envelop them. Power for togetherness should be upon them. They shall never regret in life. Failures shall never be their portion. In Jesus' name we pray. Our Father and our God, that I bless you for the life of this couple. I thank you for the life of your son, Michael, Alexander Ileva, and for the beautiful wife, Sister Marcy, Alexander Ileva. I decree into your home that your homes are full of blessing. The children shall surround your table.
Jesus Christ. God bless you. I'll put you a seat.